Feel like John Locke on Lost. Don't tell me what I can't do! Welcome back, one and all, to Le Mans! RDLMS, 12 hours of high-octane action here at Le Mans. Shock horror, horror of the shock variety. We are now coming up to the four-hour mark. On your screens is Simon Medowish, who deserves a bit of on-track action in front of the camera, because he is always the man holding it up behind the scenes. He's running currently in 29th position of the 31 teams that are still showing as classified. One of them has retired, so he will move up to 28th shortly. But he is putting in a very fine account of himself so far, 12 laps down. So far, it has been an absolute tour de force up and down the field, especially with the P1 class, because the top couple of drivers, although they're starting to spread themselves out a little bit now, have been battling and swapping for the lead constantly during this four-hour stint so far. At the moment, they're as far out as they ever have been all race, and that is at a paltry 7.5 seconds between our leader, Tim Brooke, for 05 Motorsports, and second-placed Rickard Helston for Torrent Motorsport, just 7.5 seconds behind as they start lap 70 here, and we're approaching the four-hour stint quite quickly indeed. Of course, if you're watching this live and not on YouTube, you scallywags, then... round goes our leader there, Tim Brooke. What happened there?
What are you doing?
Let's just take a quick little look. Who was he lapping there? He was back through Nigel Middleton. That was a strange... Was there contact? No, it doesn't look like there was contact from the spectator mode, but Nigel Middleton there, he was lapping. And that has lost Tim Brooke the lead, and Rickard Helston takes over for Torrent Motorsports. Ooh, dearie me. What's your thoughts on that, Jochen?
What did you say? I wasn't listening to Roy.
Oh, okay. No, did you see that spin for the leader?
Yeah, I saw it. I didn't know what happened, actually. I just saw he spun the car. He might have hit the grass during braking. He might have the back wheels during shifting down, but it's hard to say.
Well, Tim Brooke will be absolutely furious with himself with that. I think he may feel that maybe Nigel Middleton was slightly in the way, but I don't see where else he could have gone, because he was over to the right hand side of the screen as Brooke there just pops a lap on the Stroughton brothers, and onwards and upwards he goes as he tries to see what the damage limitation is. When they go past the next split, I will tell you what the gap is between Helston for TMO and Brooke for 05, but TMO take the lead again. The pineapple fritter with banana extract is now up on top. John Davies is now just 12 seconds behind the leader, but John Davies for Atlantic Racing is struggling. 3 seconds then, the gap between Helston and Brooke. I will keep an eye on that. 3.8 it says on my dashboard. John Davies then is in third position for Atlantic Racing. Let's just take a quick look at him. We'll do a rundown of the order. Oh dear, camera's having a bit of a freak out. I hope no one suffers from epilepsy, because I may fear I've set you off. this is an advanced warning now.
Yeah.
Don't do it, please. John Davies there, running in third, 12 seconds behind, keeping up but not necessarily reeling in the leaders there. If anything, actually, it's gone up slightly. Fourth position for Akuri SI Motorsport, or Sim Motorsport, is Soldatov of the Sergei variety. He's 42 seconds down. He is dropping slowly away from our leaders, but he is getting there. Oh, he's not going to get anywhere going off onto the grass like that, though. Lawn mowing, pretty much. So, that's won't be any good. Just got some news from our last place guys that they've had some damage. They're going to drive a change early. Bradley Vanian, who's been in the chat box the entire race, will be taking up the slack, so that'll be interesting to see. So that's and Tim Brooke now 5 seconds off Rickard Helston, so the gap's increasing there. One lap down, fifth position is Jean-Marie Zimgel, for Team R Seat. .fr. I'm getting there, I'm getting there. Sixth, Stefan Pearson. I want to say Pearson. Whoa! Freak out. For Atlantic Racing Team. I will just rebrand and rename everyone. It's like, oh my god, Smiro's out! Smiro's out. They've gone to change to Chummy Dion, and they're out. Oh no! Oh, come back! Yeah, he's in the garage. Oh no, what a disaster. That must have been pit related. Because it was Miro a second ago, all of a sudden it's gone to Jimmy Dion, and he's out. What a shame there for Team RSeat.fr. And that potentially will have complications for the championship, won't it?
Have some problems.
Ooh, where are they?
Position 31.
Uh-oh. I
think he went out of the track to let the traffic through, and then he just hit the wall and lost the wheel. Unless it's without the wheel.
Oh dear. Optimum Racing there really are taking over Backmarker Brigade's officialness status. So.
It's going slowly.
I tell you what, I'm quicker than that.
Yeah.
So it's not working well. Oh, it's such a shame for Team RC there, because they were really bridging the gap. So it now really is a pure four-horse race for the win now, I think, in the P1 category and overall. I'm not quite sure what's going on there, because he's going to really, really struggle to get back. I wonder if he's just kind of crawling across. But either way, he's out. Let me just see. Someone is talking to me about it. The leader's passed and hit our car. We're trying to make it back. Well, I'm not leaving the camera on it, because we've only got 8 hours left. So I don't know if we'll get back. You'll get back to the pits in time for that one.
There's someone else just from the corner.
So, yeah, so that's not good. Oh, have they? I didn't see where that was, sorry. It's all gone a bit dark. Let's have a little look. Come on. I know Rickard Helston's leading. Oh, it's gone off that screen now. He's going a little bit quicker. So yeah, that's not good. So up into what will be fifth position once everything sorts out will be Stefan Pearson for Alfa Romeo Motorsport. In fact, he is now in fifth position as he goes past Jimmy Dion. Leader of the P2 category in seventh position is Brendan Kaczmarek, who has done, I think, all of the stints so far for Alfa Romeo Motorsport. He's done very well, coming up to the four-hour mark. Of course, if you've got three drivers in your team, then it's 4 hours apiece, pretty much, if you're going to spread it out evenly. ME Racing are running in eighth position, also P2 category there for Magnus Dahlgren, the second overall in his class, looking good for Magnus. He makes his way round the ever-darkening skies of Le Mans. Ninth, Balázs Kiss. Mwah. Simco Hungarian team. I wonder if when he introduces himself in a full name variety, that is a great way to get all the ladies to kiss him. Because then they just feel obligated to have to.
It's not pronounced Kiss.
Oh, it's Kish, it's Kish, isn't
it? Kish.
Kish. A bit like Kish.
Yeah.
Kish Lorraine. Oh well. I'd rather have a kiss than the pie.
Yeah.
I'd rather have... Or you could mix the two and have a cream pie, but that would be for later. And I feel I've crossed the line once again.
Once more.
Andreas Lossler.
And fast it.
Do you know what? Every time I see that line, I feel like it's a race for the 110-metre hurdles in the Olympics, and I run for it and make sure I cross it. Maybe last. God. Do you know what? I don't think I could actually complete a hurdles race, because there is a lot of flubber that I need to get over them. I could run through the hurdles, just bruise myself quite rapidly, but there we go. If you had to do an Olympic sport, Joachim, what would you choose?
I'm not sure, actually. I'm not that good at Olympic sport, so I'm not sure. Let me throw something.
Just a person? A thing?
Yeah.
A thing?
Me? Yeah. A Graphstock, no, a pole or something.
You could get a gold midget in midget tossing.
Yeah!
The Hobbit toss. You don't have
sure,
really.
Actually.
I think, what would I do? I think just for pure hilarity, I would do rhythmic gymnastics. Ooh!
Oh, the pain!
Exactly. And yeah. if I could have like a ribbon to go round with. It's like synchronized swimming. Surely, if everyone just drowned together, they would win.
Yeah.
It'd be great. Anyway, back to the running down the order, while we can. The leaders still are separated by 5 seconds. It's not changing. Andreas Loeffler, 10th position for Black Rebels. P3 in their P2 category. Make that one out if you can. Rinus Jensen is in 11th. Jensen for Rare Endurance. Now, they did have a little meeting with the barrier at some point earlier on, but they're so far on their own, it's not so bad. 12th is... Justin Lee for Arthur R. Massive! Massive. You feel like this? Sorry, right. 13th. Moving on. That joke will be very tired by the end of the race. Sarusi Chris, or Kiss Peter.
Peter.
For Hell Racing Team Hungary, and that car has been through a lot of hell this race. 14th, and welcome to the race at the very second, pretty much, that I looked at it, Casper Mortensen. So Casper for Tams International, still going at Tams International, woo! And still without a Tam in the car. This could be why they're still running, to be fair, is that Tams, Tommy and I've forgotten the other Tam, but yeah, maybe they've decided that actually they always disconnected, so just let other people race. They're going well in 14th position. Nigel Middleton, up to 15th. Let's take a quick look at them for Total Sim Racing. Slowly ascending the order. Oh, Casper Mortensen has just spun in 14th as soon as I've clicked away from him, so that's not a good opening lap. Nigel Middleton was only 8 seconds behind, so I think this could be a little scrapperoo on our hands if that catches up. Nigel Middleton, taken over from, I'm assuming, brother Carl. Dave Simmons is just saying that it's not letting them stay in their pit box for Optimum Motorsports. I'm not quite sure what's going on there. If there is a trouble, that team will have it.
And it's the same from the Vargas head with support.
Yeah, and they've had to retire. Yeah. Oh, what a shame there.
Yeah.
For Optimum Motorsports. We're now down to just 29 teams. So, we didn't do a bet on how many people would be left, but yep, out of the race is Optimum Motorsport. Poor Dave Simmons and co, because they didn't even get a chance to get in the car. So, that's a shame. That is a shame. So, out. You are the weakest link. Goodbye. Anne was really nice. She wasn't a she was a pussy cat, really. No, she hates your guts. She's just betting paid $5 billion so that she can facelift herself even more. Schroten, Roy, and Mike, the pair, the RE pair, are 16th positions for Team Schroten, and they're doing quite well actually. And they're just ahead of Mr. Chuckle Brother himself, Roy Magnus.
Yeah, going into the pit again.
He's up in the top 20 now.
Yeah, but he has to go into the pits one more time now.
Ah, okay.
Hit the wall in the first couple of corners. second corner.
Oh, dear.
He had trouble with the steering wheel. It's too far on his right, I think, left or something. So,
Ah, okay.
Gotten the full control of the car.
Well, that is a shame, but he's still going.
Yeah.
And hopefully a little bit of repair work and that will keep things going for him. But no, right, we're cheering you on, mate. Hopefully you will get to the end of your stint quite nicely. 18th position is David Grunvell, is back in the car still for SRH Zeno. Looking good in 18th place in the car that's dark blue as it is. Now that it's in the darkness, it's going to be even more harder to see.
Switch lights and we can't see you.
Yeah. Chris Williamson is in 19th position for SRS. My god, there's an influx of people joining the channel there, so I don't know what's going on. Someone needs to turn off their telly. Or mute the broadcast. Ooh. Echo, 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 echo. Lovely. Whoever that is, can they please turn off the or mute the broadcast?
I think it's lovely.
I just
thank you. That's right, because it's a bit scary to have two of me.
Let alone one.
That is true, that is true. You're learning well. What a shame, peoples.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So talk us through it, because it was an interesting race up until then.
The accident.
Mute the broadcast, please. Whoever that is.
Bradley.
I have.
Who?
Not me.
Alright, whoever else that is needs to brute.
It
says it's you. Unless it's your microphone, maybe. Oh, there we go. That's well done, world. So, we in the commentary booth, as we continue to scroll down the order on the field. In the field, in fact, we'll look at the leaders because there's still just a couple of seconds between them. Are the Optimum Racing team? We've got Bradley Vanian, Dave Simmons, Jonathan. I'm not going to pronounce your name because you've told me about 20 million times how to do it. Thank you, Yogi. And Jonathan Matterham as well. So, I don't know who wants to start off. It can be a free-for-all sausage fest. Well, no, actually it won't be. But, yeah, just talk us through it, because you kept me entertained and I was cheering you on quite happily.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, I mean, we had a few incidents, and we lost a lot of time because we had damage to the rear wing, which meant we were about 15 kilometres an hour slow on the straight. And it didn't seem to want to fix it in the pits. So, yeah, we lost a lot of time there.
Aww. But, I mean, you was kind of on your own. It's Rickard Helston, our race leader, is into the pit lane now, handing over the lead potentially to John Davis. No, he follows you in as well. It did mean that basically you were kind of left to your own devices for the rest of the race, looking a little bit lonesome. But I hope you guys all enjoyed it, the ones that got out too, race.
It was good fun just watching it as well.
Yeah. So, and obviously both Johns were out on track, having your own little off-track excursions as well. Talk us through those.
We both, in this race we both hated the Indianapolis corner, I believe.
Yes, you had little runoffs there. But and talk us through the moment where it all came to an end there, John.
Well, there was a prototype car ahead going down the pit straight, coming out of the pits, which I was catching up with. And then there were a couple behind as well, catching up with me. And he got a bit close, and then on the exit of turn four, I was just hit on the side as I went to turn in. So I didn't see anything, but... And I have to see the replay to see exactly what happens.
Okay. Okay, so yeah, not to worry, but was this your first experience? Because I don't remember you being a team before.
Yeah, this is our first one.
Do you think you'll be back for more?
Yeah, why not?
I tell you what,
maybe I should sound a bit more enthusiastic.
I was going to say, if there was any more enthusiasm dripping off that statement, I would be so wet I'd have drowned.
But yeah, so. I mean, even on my own, it was good fun getting around the track. So.
Good stuff. Well, it's all a learning curve.
Yeah, there was also the funny lap between the crash and then when we were trying to get back to the pits. Because John didn't know that he lost a wheel.
Oh.
And I joined the server because I was planning to take over the car, and then he kept saying that he'd blown his engine, so I left. And then he says, no, it's not blown, so that's a joint rejoin again.
Yeah, but, yeah.
Well, if it was all going to go horribly wrong, at least you'd done it properly.
That's one way to look at it.
Anything you'd like to add before you sign off for the day?
No, I mean, apart from that last incident, I thought the protocol was pretty good with overtaking stuff.
Good. But no, it's been a pleasure having you all with us, even if it is surround sound. And yeah, we shall catch up with you hopefully either for next season or something else, or get yourself sorted out for the 24-hour one next month.
We already
one off. Yeah, we're working on that one.
Good. Because I intend to have 24 hours of optimum action.
We'll have to get the curly
and disaster. Tell you what, Curly Whirly, I'll bring the Walker's crisps, we'll be sorted. Okay, thank you very much, guys.
Yeah, yes. Thanks for the commentary.
Yeah, keep it up. It's great.
Thank you, Ian. Hopefully, see you in the chat box to keep me amused later on as well. Thank you very much.
Yeah, no problem.
Hey, yep, see ya.
Take it easy.
That was the gaggle of people that were Optimum Racing, unfortunately, out from last position. Who have we still got in here? Because there was a couple of other people that joined at the same time. Oh no, William's already gone, so that was all good. But just going down the field, Richard Blocker has overtaken the recently pitted Arthur Skyzula. I want to say Skyzula. I think I'm dyslexic.
Okay, this one is hard. Saikula?
Saikula. Yeah. Cooler?
Yeah.
I just need someone to say it for me once, and then I don't butcher it quite so much. I'm so glad that you're... Yeah. But Saikula is in the pits. I didn't even say it right there. Has been into the pits and just rejoined in 24th position for World Connect. And he's just ahead of the other equally difficult name to say as well. Kotliarski.
Yeah. If you just run through it, it sounds great.
Yeah.
Kotliarski.
Okay. So I see. Now that is going to turn into a really, really rude saying if I say that wrong.
Well done.
Oh dear. And now that I've got it in my head, I'm going to say it. Oh, yeah, right. Must not say that name until after 9 o'clock.
There was this lead they're telling me there was a blue for the P2 lead.
Oh.
You've got the list, I don't have it.
I've got the list, I'm on it. And it's Mr. Bauer, not from 24, and Eddie Holgren actually is saying Jeff. In fact, there's a couple of little driver changes all going on up front. The top three of the P2 teams have all changed drivers. Richard Bauer has taken over Simco Hungarian team in 8th position. Eddie Holgren has moved into R4R Motorsport in 7th position for ME Racing, obviously. Excuse me, he's only got a 40 second advantage over Bauer. And in 6th place overall in Arthur R Motorsports is Enis Doughty, so he leads that one. Not particularly a big battle that's going on, but they've all swapped drivers, so that's interesting to note. I will also say that Rickard Helson is now leading John Davies by 16 seconds, but Tim Brooke is only a further 3 seconds behind John Davies, so the battle for second overall in this race is going to start getting a little bit saucy and heated. Just talking to Jean-Marie Miro, actually, and he said he got a BSOD. Don't know what that would mean. I'm assuming it's something slightly noted.
BSOD?
Yeah. Caused by a BSOD 750 metres before giving the seat to Jimmy Dion.
Oh, blue screen of death. Roy smart.
Okay.
Blue screen of death.
Yeah.
Bob bomb. Whoa! Who was that? That was quicker
Ryan
than a whipping.
It says Ryan M.
Ah, okay. Yeah. I feel slightly violated. That was really quick. And not in a good way. Okay.
Ryan,
thank you, Ryan.
What was quick?
Well, See, what probably people don't realise because they can't hear it is that we get user joined your channel. Blah, 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 user left your channel. And yet they don't hear that, so they probably think he's just here all the way through. No, it's a good job it is switched off, actually, because otherwise, all you would hear in here is, user entered your channel, user left your channel, and this commentary would be, it would be the whore of everything going on.
The funny part is that we spend more time finding out who was in there, rather than hearing what they said.
Yeah, exactly. So, it's no good. Someone's asking to see some of Arthur's Zygula in 24th position, and well, I hate not to deliver what people are asking for, although the battle for second will be on our screens quite soon, but just while that is heating up, here he is, I'll connect competition, so take it all in, Marcel and Bobby.
I love the beetle.
If you could be a car, which car would you be?
Oh, you're getting hard. Opel Commodore B. 2.8 GSE.
Ooh. I have no idea what that is.
It's called
I'm gonna Google it now.
In England.
Vauxhall.
Vauxhall don't have a good version of it. Search Opel Commodore GSE.
Awesome. Okay, so that's a little bit of that guy there. Tim Brooke has lost 5 seconds somewhere along the line, so I'm not quite sure what has happened to him. He's just got around some traffic, so it might have been that he's lost some time there, but he's now 5 seconds behind John Davies for Atlantic Racing, so that's not worked out well at all for him. Okay, I was about to go, oh my god, it's a battle for fourth, but there's two laps between them. It's just that they were next to each other on track. Welcome to the race in ninth position, though, Kevin Ledoux for the Black Rebels. Ba-ba-bum. So, welcome, Kevy. This cold. Yeah, sorry. I've had this sodding cold for, I'd say, just over a month, and it just will not go away, and it's driving up the wall. And it's got me really angry because my manager at work came in with this cold that was stinky, and I went to her, I went, don't come near me, or you can go home. I said, I will allow you to go home. Right? And she just went, no, I can't possibly. And proceeded to like snort and blow nose all over me, and I was just a gungy, bogied mess. And I was really not impressed. And I thought, you know what? I know I'm going to get that cold now. And lo and behold, 3 days later, I feel exactly the same. And then she's like, well, no, I came in, you can't go home. And I thought, sod that, as Justin Leader just exits the pits for our massive, and we joined it back in 11th position, just about ahead of Sarusi Kispeter. In fact, quite a way ahead. But yeah, she gave me this stinky cold, and then she got better really quickly, and because I've not been allowed to have time off, and because everyone in my work works part-time except for like five people And I'm one of the full-time workers, because I can't afford to go part-time, because unfortunately I have to pay bills and stuff.
Yeah.
And so I never get the chance to go off. And at work, I have to basically interview people as to why they would like... Basically trying to tell them that they have to go back to work. So I have to talk all day. So having a bad throat and coughing all over the place, you just don't get a chance to shut up. So therefore I never recover. Disaster. In fact, Casper Mortensen has just got past Cerusi as well, so I don't know what's up with Cerusi. As there is Casper Mortensen in 12th position for Thames International. Is he in the pits? Yes, he is. Our Racing Team Hungary in the pits. It's pretty dark now, isn't it?
Yeah. I'm going to ride around the track again. It's quite dark some places. Especially down the straight.
Yeah, I was going to say, because it doesn't feel particularly well lit in some places.
No.
Do you find that it's easier when there's no lights? I know that sounds really stupid, but like you can see the other cars easier, maybe, or...
I actually like the whole
track. I would like the whole track... Yeah, yeah, I'd like the whole track covered in that Ferris wheel.
Yeah.
To be fair.
I've always...
I wonder if there's any way that we can actually get the camera to stop on the Ferris wheel, just so that I can take a quick look at it.
If you press it on your keyboard, then you can... switch cameras around.
Which button?
End.
Ah. I'll wait until we get around. But we're just watching there, Stephen Poobles. Although we're now on a straight where there was some lights. You saw a bit there where there was no lights whatsoever, so... Very difficult to kind of work out what's going on there. Because it's such a long track as well, admittedly, thankfully, there is no corners going on, particularly throughout. Just reading a chat box, giggles. I don't know, it's one of those longer tracks, so it takes a while to get inbred in your brain, I suppose.
Yeah.
Like having it completely in the dark, say around like the Nordschleife or something like that. Oh, I can't remember what corner comes next in the daylight. God knows where it would be in the dark.
You have to memorise it.
Yeah.
Quite.
I don't think that will happen for me. I have trouble memorising my name.
You have the easiest name.
So 28 teams running. We're just watching last place Stephen Poobles there for a little bit. The gap between Rickard Helsen and John Davies is still 14 seconds. Nothing really changing there. Tim Brooke is really dropping off the back in third position. He's now 28 seconds off the leader. And that's a shame. I think he must have picked up some damage when he'd done that spin crash. Because he's not been the same man since. And we've been joined in the chat room by P2 Leaders. Let's bring him up on the screens. Brendan Kaczmarek. Hey, Brend.
Hello, hello. How are you guys?
How you doing?
Doing all right, I think. I mean, we're leading class, so can't complain too much.
No.
A little fumble on the strategy, I think. I was supposed to start with a triple with the usual 6 a.m. qualifying and all the stuff that comes with living on the East Coast here. But I managed to tear the splitter off on my outlap of the third stint. So in order not to have to worry about fixing a damage with handing over to Ennis, I just did the damage and manned up and did another stint. So it's all worked out so far, I think. We've got a solid minute or so.
Yeah, it's going... And aside from that one moment, I mean, how was the car without the splitter? Because we've seen a couple of cars be able to stay out at the moment.
Yeah, this is, it seems like half the P2 field is out there without splitters. Every time I came across another car, it was missing a front end. But this is the second time we've done it. We had to do it at Daytona as well. And on tracks that are low downforce already, tearing the splitter off gets rid of more drag than it does actual grip. The corners here, apart from, you know, Tetra Ridge and a couple of sections of Porsche curves, are slow enough that it's all mechanical grip anyway. So, you know, you'll take the couple of miles an hour in a straight line rather than, you know, taking the aero hit. So we only lost maybe a second or a second and a half a lap.
Oh, okay. Which I suppose is that you're not out there long enough to really gain back a whole pit stop, even if you did pit for repairs anyway, so that's not too bad, actually. I thought it would be a lot worse.
No, definitely. And it happened on my outlap, so, you know, I'd have been straight back in the pits, and it would have been, you know, just a straight loss of a minute. There's no way to gain back from that, so...
Too much drama llamas to be bothering with that. So what's the plan for the rest of the race, apart from win?
Well, we haven't really got one. I mean, our only goal coming into this one was to finish well enough to lock up the championship. And we can do that with a third, regardless of what the Simcoe Hungarian team does. Fortunately, roles are reversed. They're sitting third, we're leading. So, you know, I'm quick enough in the daylight. I can do a pretty consistent 16, low 16s. On boost mode. So we've got fuel strategy on our side, and we've got pace on our side. So at this point, Ennis will take it through the beginning of the night. I'll probably get back in and take it back towards dawn, and then I think he'll wind up finishing.
Okay. Awesome stuff. And how else is life treating you these days, Brendan?
Oh, it's fine. You know, a whole handful of races going on, endurance races. Finishing up the season here, we've got ERL, VLMS ERL season we're in the middle of, finally getting some luck. We DNF'd three in a row and finally came back and won one.
So that evens out quite nicely.
It will if we win some more. We're not counting ourselves out of a championship yet, but we're a long way back. So, and you know what? Proper racing is back. Went down to the Rolex 24 a couple of weeks ago. Did my usual marshalling bit, and Sebring coming up in a couple of weeks, so it's good to be back in the season.
Woohoo, and you're definitely keeping yourself busy. We're just watching an ongoing battle about to occur for 7th and 8th, behind your guys actually. Eddie Holgren from E-Racing has been caught hand over fist by Richard Bauer for Simcoe. So hopefully those two, well, hopefully from your point of view anyway, those two continue to battle, end up holding each other up even further, gets you a bigger lead.
Yeah, and they definitely have. I mean, they had a scrap earlier on, and they just keep losing more and more time. So we'd like to see the Simcoe car further back. We're not in the Emmy car isn't in contention for the championship, but you know what? We win it anyway. It doesn't matter. So there's our strategy.
Not good at all. Just looking at 28th position. Maurice Zondag, slow on track for SRVN, not quite sure what he's doing, he's pulled over to the side of the track.
Looks like he's leaning over.
Yeah, I think he's in trouble. He's flashing his lights as if to say, please stay away. So, that won't help. The way out there,
actually,
all...
in the dark, it's incredibly hard to see these cars.
Really?
You approach them so fast. If they're only doing 90 or 100 miles an hour, well, that's still pretty quick. Even the P2 cars are doing, you know, 80 or 90 miles an hour better than that. And I had more than one occasion where I almost slammed into the back of various slow GT and prototype cars that don't make themselves quite so visible. With them being so dark, it's hard to anyway, so...
I think he has a puncture.
Yeah, he's lost a tyre, by the looks of it. I've been told by... Ryan and Sausage.
Sausage.
I've forgotten his name. He's been nicknamed Sausage, but yeah, he's plodding along down the straight quite nicely, getting along, and Simon Mellowish has already overtaken him, as has, well, Poobles actually is just a lap further down, and he's in the pits actually, so as is Person. So lots of action going on, but hopefully Zondag can get it back to keep Crashcast alive. Come on, man. Come on, you can do it. You can do it.
I'm gonna step away, guys, so you guys have a good rest of the race, and we'll see you at the end, hopefully.
Awesome. Thank you very much for popping in. That was Brendan Kaczmarek, the leader of the P2 category at the moment for ME Racing, as Zondag continues to limp back to the pits. Let's just jump back to this battle for 7th and 8th overall in the race, but 2nd in a P2 class. And actually, Richard Bauer has lost time. Is it to me? I'm not sure. Yeah, he has. He's lost something. In fact, what's going on is Jerome Sausage is just saying that Zondag's trying to get back to the pits. Don't know if it will be repaired. That would be a shame. So hopefully, thanks for the airplay. I'm sorry that it's just showing him going along at 2 miles an hour, but this looks very suspicious of what happened to Optimum Racing and also Waterblue Racing, where they got back to the pits and it just sent. It poked and laughed at the car and just went, nah, we're not repairing that.
I want that. Let's get it out. Or it was somewhere else.
Yeah, gets out some masking tape for it, and it's like, bit pretty stick. Cohen Velinde is next up on the list for Maurice Zondag to lose out to. So he is in 29th position. And last of the runners, 15 laps down. And he's only just joined back in the car there as Cohen. He started off the race, he's now back going in it again. So he's doing well. Let's see if Maurice is up to these days. Of course, always gets a lot of stick because Zondag in Dutch means Sunday, so everyone calls him the Sunday driver. Which I'm sure he will be delighted for me to tell everyone.
I think we've mentioned that in every stream.
I know. I don't like him to forget. Hello, Thomas, by the way. Welcome to the chat box. Of course, if you want to take part in the chat box, just pop across to the racedepartment.com. And up on the top there, we've got live streams. Click on that. We're on stream one. And if you don't know that, but you've still managed to hear me say we're on stream one, I would be very shocked as to how you managed to do so. But we are on there. And a little chat box behind you. You should come and join the other 100 plus users, because we're having a gang bang. Well, not really, but it's all looking good.
We need to pass the 15,000 viewers mark today.
We do. I don't know why I set that as a target, but I just thought, you know what, it sounds really unrealistic, let's have a go.
No, it's not unrealistic. But
what did we get last time? It was over 10, wasn't it?
11?
Something like that. I just thought, well, we've got a couple of extra hours. What we might ask people to do is, if we're not looking like hitting the target, we need to basically go and get everyone to keep reconnecting to the broadcast about every minute.
Yeah.
And if you all do it in the hundreds.
Viewers.
Yeah. Oh, is it?
Oh,
round. Goes Robin Dijon.
And there comes.
And Rickard Helston. Rickard Helston is our leader for Torrent Motorsport. Dijon is for SRVN, and the other SRVN car is still in trouble. He's not made it to the pits yet as Zondag. He wasn't involved in that, they just all spun off their own accord. I think.
Maybe.
Okay, Robin Dijon though, back going again in 21st position. Let's see what the gaps are now. John Davies now just 11 seconds behind Rickard Helston. So it has closed the gap. Robin Dijon in 21st position has also got back going again from that spin. There he is. It's actually quite hard to see what's going on in this broadcast in some way. Oh! Dijon's got it wrong. Oh, and that's going to be an awful re-entry if he goes in like that. Oh dear, Robin Toll must have had his heart in his mouth. And that was about to cause problems for the battle over 7th and 8th with Holgren and Bauer. Still only about 2 seconds separating them tops. And they were going through on that as well. But Robin Dijon doing it all very wrong on lap 70 of his race. Let's see what's going on. Here's Zondag reaching the pits at long last. And yeah, that car looking a little bit beaten and whipped. Cohen Velinde has passed. Simon Melewisch has retaken the has put the car into the pits for Ryan Walker to take over. Should we do a drum roll to see if they repair it? Dijon feeling the need to pit there as well. I've given up on the drum roll because he's taken so long to get down the pit lane. Is no good. So in he is. Oh, well, they're doing something. That is the worst camera angle possible.
I think that's on their touch.
Not aimed. Let's go for Yeah, he's out. Oh no, he's not out. No, he's not. Well, it says. Oh, I'm not sure. It's having a fit. Yeah, he's out. Murray Zondag out of the race. What a shame. Poor old Crash Casty. I'm sure he'll pop in and give us something to show what's happened. Ricard Helston now 10.8 ahead of John Davies. Let's go back to the Richard Bauer battle over 7th and 8th positions just to see what's going on with those two as they cross the line to start their 79th lap, 2.2 the gap. So, yeah, unable to fix there, says Jerome Sausage. So that's a shame. Oh, Kevin Ledoux, they're running slow in 9th position, I think. What's he done? Oh no, he's not running slow, that was just the camera angle, don't mind me. Slow coach. The things are finally starting to spread out ever so slightly here. Still a couple of battles going on.
7th hour to go.
Shush. And we've got a new driver on the track. And it's Richard Bauer there, getting past Eddie Holgrin. Holgrin having an awful exit out of one of those corners. He must have been in trouble, and Richard Bauer pounces through for Simcoe Hungarian team, up into 7th position in the darkness here at Le Mans. So, Simcoe Hungarian Racing up to 7, ME Racing down to 8. And Holgrin doesn't appear to have an answer, because even though he's sitting in the slipstream, he's not really closing in. And if Bauer can just break that 1 second toe, which he's looking close to doing, he may well actually be through. So, this of course battling for second overall in the P2 category and class, it's going to be an excellent way to see what's going to happen. As here we have actually into the commentary booth there, Stefan Persson there. How you doing?
Ah, good evening, sirs. Any of your shirts left?
No.
Did Simon eat them all?
Yeah, I'm getting it.
Sorry. I'm a fat bitch, what can I say?
Oh, he's trying to send me some cookies through the and I glowered up, but...
Yeah, slap his moobs. That gave me a good laugh, that.
Oh dear. Never mind.
Okay, back to serious stuff.
Serious? On a broadcast?
There's a race going on, have you seen it?
No,
it's too dark.
No, well, yeah, it is too dark.
Black.
Yeah. It's not going well, but you're going well at the moment.
Well, we are improving. We had some issues in the third. The start Ambrose didn't work out as we thought. We had
no
issues.
That was such a PC way of saying it.
Yeah, it was. I should have mentioned things in podcast.
No.
So we had some issues, and we decided to try it, and we did a small improvement, and then we said, okay, we're going to do a swap, because this is getting out of hand, and he wasn't enjoying his stint, so I took over, and I drove as a noob my first half hour. I had such a problem getting through the Porsche curves, you wouldn't believe it. My second stint was, everything was falling into places, lap times were soon improving, traffic was getting much, much better. Not so many issues. And, just trying to do consistent lap, not make mistakes, because all the teams are almost equal in lap times, apart from a few really quick ones, and apart from a few not so quick. But so it was bury the head down and just go for it.
But at least it's all going in the right direction now.
Oh yeah, absolutely. I think things are looking really, really good for Atlantic at the moment. I think Jürgen just joined now and he's going to go for the night session. I don't know if he's going to double stint or what. I think he's going to do a double.
If you've decided he's doing a double.
Oh, it's like... How is your mojo at the moment? Do you feel like, I can do this forever? Then you can do like three stints or even four. I managed. I think I did four. I had to get to bits on repair, but but it was enjoyable. It's a great looking track.
Do you ever get slightly bored on all the straights?
I wasn't going to bring that up, but yes, like hell. I was picking my nose, like...
Oh. Reading the paper.
No, not reading the paper. Well, I was looking at the time, because I'm really hungry now, so I need to go and get something to eat, but I was looking at the clock, coming down the straight.
Time to put on tea. So we should get you like a Kindle or something so that you could just scroll through a book on the straight as you go along.
Yeah.
A TV.
Maybe just buy a Kinder egg. You
know, yeah.
And build a small toy, get inside. Oh, look, a bird. Oh, touch spray. I did get Tim behind my back from the Fire Motorsport, and I got the blue flag. And I said, all I need to do is back off, because if I stay, I'm going to get a penalty. So I let Tim pass me right after the Indianapolis, down towards the Anarch complex. And then I just, tagged along. And I gained him in some parts, and he disappeared in some parts. And I thought, okay, if I can keep a reasonably good pace with Tim, I'm doing okay. And, traffic separated us.
Aww.
Well, it was good. Then he had some issues coming down to Tête Rouge, I think, where the Ferris wheel is.
Oh, yeah.
And he crashed really, really hard. I think that was GT2 traffic, to be honest.
There were so many cars that I didn't notice.
Well, nothing to watch. but I think he's on pace
nothing
again.
To see here.
No, easy. Is he not?
Bless. No. All is good in the world. Now, this voice sounds quite...
I'm just going to end by saying, I'm going to send my hellos from the whole team drivers to our team boss, Mario Rockers, who's he's a bit sick. He's in bed. Well, he should be in bed. He's certainly not... gonna sit in front of his computer watching this race. And I wish him a speedy recovery, and hope we can make him really happy today.
Aww, well, we'll send him out a fruit basket.
You do that, please.
And maybe a cuddly toy.
Okay, good. Well, Simon and Joachim, you need to get back into what you're doing. I need to go eat something.
Okay.
Okay,
I'll get some super noodles, take care.
No, I'm gonna get a steak.
Ooh.
Yeah, huge one. Okay, goodbye.
Take it easy. Thanks for coming in. Cheers, Stefan Pierce, Pearson, who... He sounds suspiciously like the infamous man from last time that we nearly got taken off air.
Maybe.
La la la. But much, much more PG orientated this time. Welcome to the race, 23rd position, Jan Wim Ensing for SRV and GT2. Welcome to the race, also in 25th position, Alex Reynas for Team Sim Motorsport. He's doing well. Ryan Walker's back in the seat for Total Sim Racing. Wayne Reed, I said it right, back in for Total Sim Racing as well, P2 and GT2 classes respectively. Well, not respectively, the other way round, actually. Let's just hash that one up completely. And now that the battle for second in the P2 category has finished, not tons and tons of battles going on out on track where people are right next to each other at the moment. A couple of people are still relatively close. We've got Ben Warren and Kieran Peace are on the same lap, yet Ben Warren is a P2 car. Ooh, what happened there?
Roy spun the car and someone hit them.
15th position.
Soldato. That's the P1 Peugeot.
What position are they in?
I'm not sure.
I've got Grunvals in 16th position stuck somewhere.
Soldato.
Okay. Yeah, I've got it. Fourth position. So far, Grunvald's there is running slowly, just getting back going again. He's just about to be taken, I think, by Roy Magnus, if not anything at all. And Solotov is in drama. Now, don't say R for Roy. He's overtaking people.
No. Roy spun the car and Soldato hit him.
Ah, okay. Roy, you bad man. We'll get out George's whip. So... And that is a good point there, Neil Heckens. Those fans next to the track have a lot of batteries for their cameras because they've been taking pictures for 5 hours now. I tell you what, they are ever-iddies.
That's quite true.
Soldatov is into the pits, as is Grunvald, who was caught up in that accident as well. Mr. Melhuish, welcome to the right side of the camera for once. How'd you get on?
Good evening. Not so good. I had a few deep spins.
Oh, we didn't see any of them.
The first bit was when I was trying to give the needles some space to the wall side, a bit wide, and it just slipped around. And just
we saw that one.
The wheel just goes back. I'm like, oh.
So it didn't even give you any let up at all?
No, well, I had a late call to get in the car because I was supposed to be driving the one of the Ferraris, but I didn't like the car and I wasn't going to race. Then Ryan said he kept driving to see the teammate, so I jumped in last minute.
Aww, good sport.
Yeah, so it's a bit of a minefield trying to work out what this car does and stints and stuff.
But did you find that you was improving over the stint, or...?
I couldn't really tell. It was after that crash, I lost the bottom pen, so I was really slow. It was like 10 seconds off what the leaders are doing, so we're just sort of cruising around trying to finish the thing.
Okay, but no. Well, hopefully you do get up for a good old finish. And what's it like being back behind the wheel? Because so often you're actually Mr. Cameraman and you don't get a chance to turn a wheel in anger as much as what you should be allowed to do. So it must be nice to be out there racing fully.
Well, I've been to get my racing mix in the Le Mans series, which is an American series.
Oh, okay.
Then this popped up, so it's been good to get another drive because obviously their races are only once a month, so...
Okay. So, and for anyone who's interested in that kind of thing, where would they go for that?
Vilas-url.com.
Ooh, that's delicious. Loving that. Welcome to the race in fourth position for Akuri Sim Motorsport, Dennis Porokaniak. I didn't butcher that one quite as much as I should have done. So that weren't too bad.
That means you're learning.
No, just means I've not had enough beer.
Oh.
In fact, the beer is on the hold, waiting to come out. So will you be back out again? Cool.
Also nice to see my actual TMO car in the lead. Wasn't really expecting that because that car also got a late call up to be able to race.
Haha.
That's why the
cars
are orange, not the normal colours.
I did wonder, actually. So, because I knew that he was looking at new liveries, but no, it's doing a rather nifty job. It's got a 14-second lead now over John Davis for Atlantic, and Tim Brooks dropping away half a minute down now in third. So, I'm assuming you're targeting the win for that, but it'll be a surprise win, would you say?
With the lack of preparation, it'd be brilliant to win the race, but I think we'd be happy with the podium, to be honest.
Cool. Oh, wow.
Still got Dave Cosby to get in the car. He's
oh dear.
The car, so don't say that.
DCS. Well, the problem is with DCS is that you can't let him be in the lead when he starts a stint because that is just going to curse it.
There's not seen someone who's on not going to be there to push him to the pits like in FSR a few years ago.
No, that was team tactics down to a T. That was. If anyone's not seen that, they need to pop it onto a tube of the U variety now. Well, not now, actually. Yes, I am spacing out the beer, Oscar. I promise. My twin. Oscar Hardwick, actually, with a surname like that, you probably are my twin.